We're here at the UC Berkeley Seismology Station where they reported the strong earthquake at exactly 5:04 p.m.
Their equipment went off the scale. This quake was so sharp. Epicenter 10 miles northeast of Santa Cruz.
We can expect some aftershocks. We've already had some aftershocks.
On Tuesday, October 17th, 1989, at 17 hours, 4 minutes, 15 seconds Pacific Daylight Time, a strong motion earthquake emanated from a location 60 miles south-southeast of San Francisco near Loma Prieta in the Santa Cruz mountain range. The main shock, the largest to strike the San Francisco Bay Area since 1906, ruptured a segment of the San Andreas Fault and at a magnitude of 7.1. On October 26, 1989, at the direction of CHP Commissioner Maury Hannigan, a special investigation team comprised of accident reconstruction specialists from the California Highway Patrol was formed. This team was established to identify, collect, and document all of the factual information and available data from the earthquake-induced failure and collapse of two major bi-level elevated interstate freeway structures. Two 50-foot-long roadway segments of Interstate 80 on the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge collapsed, along with a 3/4-mile-long segment of Interstate 880 freeway known as the Cypress Street Viaduct. On October 17th at 5 p.m., as the third game of the 1989 World Series was about to begin, the wind was from the northwest at 13 knots. Barometric pressure was 29.97, dew point was 45 degrees, visibility was 8 miles, and the temperature around the Bay Area was 75 degrees.
First time in 27 years a World Series game will be played in Candlestick Park. The Battle of the Bay continues.
At second base, so the Oakland A's take.
Hey, well, we have an error.
There go the lights.
911.
Yeah, this is an emergency in San Francisco. What happened?
There's a hell of an earthquake, and we've got windows and everything that's falling out. We've got a hell of a dust cloud.
How is the total emergency?
Cypress section of the West Grand Freeway has come down.
The Cypress structure has collapsed.
25238, we have a major injury accident, Cypress and West Grand. They're advising major injuries. We're attempting to get 1141.
We have a 50-foot section, which is collapsed from westbound into eastbound.
Said the upper deck collapsed onto lower deck.
From westbound into eastbound, east of TI.
How is the total emergency?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Steve Barnes. I'm at West Grand Avenue. And Cypress section of the West Grand Freeway has come down. I saw at least 3 or 4 trucks come over the top.
I think the whole section of the overhead just collapsed.
Okay.
Overhead.
Our Cypress structure in Oakland has just fallen through.
We'll check the ambulance response is 3-2 in Cypress.
We can go to 880 in Cypress.
Between the streets of, between 17th Street, as far as I can see, going towards 32nd. So we're going to need some trucks down here as soon as you can get them.
Oakland 2, engine 5.
Engine 5.
We need a truck at 32nd and Cypress. The entire...
Just gonna start on that top rung until we get some security up there.
Okay.
We got 2 bodies down here?
Yeah.
Alright. We're gonna slide them down.
Truck at 32nd of Cypress. The entire overhead of the freeway is down all the way to Highway 580. We need a truck company at 32nd of Cypress. Do you have ambulances coming to 32nd of Cypress? And also truck company if you've got one available.
John, we got 1 casualty right here. It's going to be in between decks with people trapped. So let's start to see if we can get a ladder in here.
I'll have to go around the block.
Oh,
Oakland 2.
Yeah, they have people trapped on Cypress. I want you to respond to Cypress and work your way towards West Grand Avenue. They have people trapped all along. You are to respond to 32nd and Cypress.
Yes, Fire Alarm, a truck company, 32nd and Cypress. See me up here on the freeway, pull forward.
Central copy, a westbound section has collapsed into the eastbound section at a 50-foot section.
Okay, let me check.
Before we had, there was a lot of people hurt under where it collapsed.
Okay, let me check.
Yes, we're getting the calls on that now.
All right, ma'am.
Gas collapsed, yes, and we're trying to get all these people off the bridge now.
So you're just going to turn the cars around and try to get them off?
Get them off the best way we can. Yes, ma'am.
Traffic, he wants the bridge closed down on the west side until we find out how long it's going to be closed.
Turn them around at the Sterling Street exit, get them going the wrong way, evacuate this portion of the bridge. That's the only way we're going to clear this deck. 2,000 to 3,000 people outside of their cars, west of the tunnel to east of the tunnel.
The eastbound needs to be shut down at the west end. Then get the motors turned around and going the wrong way and clear them off that way so that we get the entire bridge shut off and get the cars off the bridge.
We've got a lot of freeway down here.
32 is refueling, and CalSTAR and life support are going to send as many helicopters as possible, but they'll have to go to the Cypress structure first. We have people trapped underneath.
Three pillars down in the center section. There should be two live people. You might be able to use your 24-foot ladder to get to them.
We need a pumper. We have a semi-trailer truck on fire under the collapsed portion of the freeway.
This is Engine 1. Check, get a battalion chief down here. We've got four injured now here. Watch, get some aftershocks. We just got one.
Good. On the freeway collapse, there's a multi-casualty unit at 17th and Cypress. Bring all your injuries to 17th and Cypress.
We'll need a couple ambushes if you've got them in your hip pocket at 30 seconds in the freeway collapse.
Well, we just got the ladder down now.
He's down the block. It's real bad down here, Andy.
10 Cypress incidents. They're working on extrication of three children.
Oh, it's part of this collapse stuff, Alan, but I don't have any company up that way, and we have fire and people trapped. Put people trapped at that end and just begin to work their way down to West Grand Avenue.
Yeah, they have people trapped on Cypress. I want you to respond to Cypress and work your way towards West Grand Avenue. They have people trapped all along.
We're going to work our way all the way down. You've got rescues going independently with people with contractor and equipment. We've got cops, we've got CHP, we've got civilians. So what we need to do is start probably working our way down, keep one lane of traffic clear, work our way into each incident and get an analysis. We've got about a half a mile of a collapsed structure. Every bit is going to have to be searched. You're going to have to pull out the stops and call for a general alarm.
Bumper 1 is on Cypress, somewhere between West Grand and 20th. We need a hearse tool. We need a hearse tool right now.
Give the hearse tool right alongside American Steel in between 17th and 20th. Also, for your information, we have CHP helicopters here evacuating people, Carl.
Bumper 1, I need my hearse tool, please.
Total chaos. It's terrible. It's terrible. There's a lot of people under this pit.
Whoever's coming out of the incident, we've got four people pinned.
People trapped at Cypress and Campbell.
Humping and jumping, and the cars were falling down. The dust was like, the dust was going all over. Rocks were flying. People
need in time and as much heavy rescue equipment as we can.
Truck 15, meet Engine 5 at 32nd and Cypress. They need a truck.
Yeah, we need the jaws of life.
Get another engine company.
The upper deck of the bridge has collapsed. It collapsed onto the lower deck and then went into the water.
At 5:35 p.m., 31 minutes after the earthquake, a 1980 Mercury Zephyr, driven by a 23-year-old woman, entered the westbound upper deck of the Bay Bridge and drove eastbound in the wrong direction for approximately 2 miles. The vehicle was traveling at approximately 49 miles per hour when it became airborne and flew 35 and one-half feet across the gap and impacted the fallen portion of the upper roadway deck.
This car managed to get on the bridge. It tried to fly across this 50-foot gap and didn't make it.
After impact, the front wheels became caught and suspended the vehicle and its occupants high above the lower deck.
3283 and units on the bridge. Coast Guard helicopter advises they have reports of injuries in that area and are available for medevac. They are over you now. Repeating, 32 units on the bridge. They have reports of injuries. The Coast Guard helicopter is over the bridge at this time and are available for medevac.
Report we had, there was a lot of people hurt on there where it collapsed.
81, are you closer to the collapsed area of the bridge? If so, the Coast Guard helicopter will be flying overhead and we're there for medevac to take injuries out if necessary.
Both the driver and her brother were extricated and transported to Letterman Army Hospital by Coast Guard helicopter. The driver of the vehicle was pronounced dead on arrival. Her brother was hospitalized with major injuries. The results of the California Highway Patrol's investigation revealed that the driver did not appear to brake and took no other apparent evasive action before driving into the gap created by the collapse of the westbound deck. An examination of the driver's side restraint system indicated it was not in use at the time of impact. The passenger, however, was wearing a seatbelt and survived.
Oakland 2, this is Chief 2.
Stand by, Chief. Engine 5, I'll check for you, ETA.
And I'll check on you if you've got one available.
Yeah, I think we're clear on the upper deck. All the damage is going to be in between decks.
Talk 1, disregard the response to Vernon. Chief, you are to respond to 32nd and Cypress.
Got it. Check 1. Talk 1.
Oakland.
When we first found him, it was about a half an hour after the earthquake, and the structure was still falling, so we chocked it and used large jacks to keep it from falling down any further, and through perseverance and persistence, we got him out. He was caught underneath the steering wheel. When the structure fell, he was off to the right side. That's the only thing that helped him survive. His right leg was underneath the dash, and that's what was preventing him from being extracted. We cut the seat, pulled the stuffing out from under the seat, cut the springs out from the seat to help him drop down, and the fire guys were just incredible. They are the ones that I would say did the 98% of the job.
In one crushed car, a 7-year-old boy was trapped beneath the body of his dead mother. To save the boy, the mother had to be removed. Surgeon James Betts.
Decision was made at that time to actually remove as much of her as we could, knowing that we couldn't totally extricate her. The other surgeon and I decided that the best way to do this would be to literally divide her body, and that's what we did.
The boy was still trapped, and doctors were forced to amputate part of his leg.
And I literally had to lie on my stomach on the corner of the back seat of this car to reach down inside to get to his leg.
I think deep in my heart, I felt that if it were my child or the family would be able to be there, that they would agree with any decision possible to go ahead and save the life of this boy.
As several agencies converged on the structure, it became obvious that heavy construction equipment would be the only means of accessing the trapped bodies. Once the location of all of the vehicles was established, special cement cutting tractors were used to open large holes over the crushed vehicles. This allowed for access to the trapped victims, some of whom had been in vehicles that were now compressed to 12-inch high slabs. Others were badly disfigured or burned beyond recognition. This made the coroner's identification process and the California Highway Patrol's vehicle identification process very difficult. It took a total of 10 days to recover all of the 41 bodies. 4 days after the earthquake, a Caltrans engineer investigating a dark, unstable section of the Cypress observed movement in a crushed car. An immediate rescue effort ensued.
57-year-old male by the name of Buck, B-U-C-K, first name, last name Helms, H-E-L-M-S. He was just extricated and removed from a location around 28th Street.
Hospital in Oakland. The news there is...
Because the uncollapsed portion of the 32-year-old viaduct was severely damaged, a decision was made to immediately begin demolition. Dismantling of 80,000 tons of concrete and steel rubble continued until early 1990. Once removed, the surface roadway known as Cypress Street was repaired and reopened. Construction on the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge began in July of 1933. On November 12, 1936, the 5.5-mile-long span opened for traffic. The Bay Bridge is the world's largest span and is the only bridge to incorporate four major types of bridge construction. The bridge carries 250,000 vehicles a day, the third largest traffic volume in the United States. At the collapse site, a steel tower supports the roadways 200 feet above the San Francisco Bay. When the earthquake struck, a force of 2 million pounds sheared 40 one-inch thick bolts. These bolts were all that secured the entire eastern portion of the bridge to the tower. As the roadways began to move, the upper and lower decks were pulled off their supports and collapsed. The blue vehicle was nearly stopped when it rode the top deck downward. The van was struck by the falling upper deck and was catapulted off the collapsed lower deck. The red car slowed and barely nosed over into the open gap. Construction crews worked 24 hours a day for 30 days to complete the repairs needed to reopen the bridge. They removed the damaged 160-ton roadways, then realigned the 3,000 feet of bridge from the tower to Oakland. And finally, the roadways were paved and the bridge reopened November 17, 1989. The Cypress Structure Viaduct was California's first double-deck freeway. 1.5 miles long, it opened in June of 1957 at a cost of $9 million. Normally, there would be approximately 200 vehicles on both levels of the 3/4-mile section that collapsed. However, there were only 107 vehicles caught on the upper and lower decks of the structure when it fell. At the time of the structure's collapse, most vehicles had slowed from 59 miles per hour to an average speed of approximately 38 miles per hour on the southbound upper deck. and from 57 miles per hour to approximately 32 miles per hour on the northbound lower deck. The majority of the 58 vehicles on the lower deck were crushed by the falling upper deck or drove into the collapsed cement and steel support beams. Of the 49 upper deck vehicles, some were slammed into the roadway surface. Others were catapulted over raised sections of exposed freeway or collided with other vehicles. Six vehicles were launched from the upper deck and fell to the surface streets below. Those vehicles not stopped by the collapsed structure bounced, rolled, or slid for as many as 14 seconds before coming to a stop. The California Highway Patrol's analysis of vehicle motion indicates that the Cypress structure began collapsing at four separate sites, 4 seconds after the structural motion was perceived by people driving on the viaduct. The progressive failure radiated north and southward from each of these sites. Approximately 2 seconds later, the entire structure had collapsed. This is only a summary of the California Highway Patrol's response and findings concerning the October 17, 1989 seismic shaking of the San Francisco-Oakland Bay Bridge and the Cypress Street Viaduct, two of the effects of the Loma Prieta earthquake.
50-foot bridge collapse from westbound into eastbound, east of TI. Do you have anyone trapped inside?
We're at the incident at 880 along Cypress. We have a complete structural collapse of the entire freeway between the streets of, between 17th Street, as far as I can see, going towards 32nd. So we're going to need some trucks down here as soon as you can get them.
Truck is upside down. Truck at 32nd of Cypress. The entire overhead of the freeway is down all the way to Highway 580. We need a truck company at 32nd of Cypress.
Damage is going to be in between decks with people trapped, so let's start.